nice and tight. I put quite a bit of tension on my string. I'm not worried. Oops. If you wrap the tail in, it's okay. Just pull it out. I do that all the freaking time. Just pull it back out. I am not worried about losing things out the bottom, if things crumble and fall. That's not my worry. My worry is always bundling too loose. So you're just gonna keep going around in a spiral. So if you can kind of see some of the string at this point, it's making a spiral down the herbs, and that's kind of what you want. You can start twisting it if you need to readjust your hand. I kind of will get pretty close to the end, and then I'll go around a couple times pulling tight, and then I try to go around at least 3 or 4 times. And even though I'm talking through this, in the back of my mind, I actually say like a little blessing, a little thank you in my internal monologue, blessing the herbs, thanking the earth, my team and whatever for allowing me, you know, the privilege of having this. And then what you do is you'll come back. And so all of these spirals are going like this. When you come back up your bundle, you're going to go the other way, so they form an X. So when I go back down, I'm going to go the opposite direction. Oops. It's okay. You don't have to be perfect. You can take a super amount of time and make it perfect if that's what makes, you know, it enjoyable for you. I'm not super concerned about it, so I don't get too crazy. But you can see the crisscross pattern. Pull nice and tight. Give it a pinch. You're going to want to watch the tail again as you get near the end for the same reason as before. We want to leave the tail out. Sometimes I'll kind of hold it away with a finger and then push it with a thumb. Hold it with a finger, push it with a thumb. And I'll come all the way back down to the base. And then I'll just remake sure that my tail is not stuck. And I'll go around the base several more times. And then what I do is I actually will make another knot. I'll make another knot with my tail just to kind of hold that string. And then I cut several inches away. So I'm not worried about the waste on the string, because if you go to hang dry, then you're going to be doing that anyway. And then now that it's all held in place and I don't have to worry about tension, I go ahead and I do another knot. Not with my first tail. But I go ahead and I do another like pull through knot. And then I crank down on her. And then just a simple overhand knot. I don't want my stuff coming undone. It's kind of a pain in the butt if it does, to be honest. So that's that. So now you have your bundle. I like the ends to be neat. And it's not wasteful, because I will save all of it as loose herbs. So I take a scissor and I cut it off. I find it easier for lighting if it's flat. And then kind of same thing with the end. I'll cut a little bit of this end off and a little bit of this pointy end off. And then I save all of this. I put it in a jar for loose burning. The herbs don't lose their property whether they're in the bundle or they're loose, so feel free to use them with a charcoal disc. Now, if you wanted to hang dry, you take both your strings, both tails, and you can make a little knot at the back. I have too big of a fingers for this. You make a little knot, and then what that allots you is a little tiny loop. It's kind of hard to see because I have big fingers. I'm so sorry. I don't hang dry, so I never worry about it. But you can kind of see the loop here that it makes. I hope you can see it. So you have a knot and a loop. So if you wanted to hang it via the loop, you totally could. So at this point, it's good. I like the tightness of it. You can go around a million times with string if you really wanted to. You do not have to. I just do it enough so the herbs are nice and tightly packed. I put this back in the dehydrator until it's completely dry. The color will change. It will no longer be as green as it is here. I love the smell of this, especially because I put my own little in the middle of it. So when you get down to about like the first half inch, you have so much stuffed in between the leaves. It's not even funny. But yeah, so that's how you make a sage bundle. I hope this helps. Have fun with it. Be creative, you know. Yeah. Bye, B. Get out there and do some fun-ass shit, man. You know? Have some fun, bro.